This morning we're going to look at a passage that we believe has gotten twisted, and it has to do with a question, a difficult question, of why did God require all those animals to be butchered in the Old Testament? What was up with that? And that, since those animals are supposed to be a prototype of the sacrifice of Christ, why did Jesus need to die for us to be saved? But why must there be the shedding of blood for the forgiveness of sins? Now, the most common answer that's given among conservative Protestants, especially over the last 500 years or so, probably it's the answer that many of you, maybe most of you, were taught, is that the blood is required because God must vent his wrath against sin. God is too holy to have any fellowship with sinners unless the sin is covered by the blood, unless it's atoned for, unless a sacrifice is made. His wrath needs to be appeased. God, yes, he's love, but he's also justice. And those two must be reconciled. And so reconcile is justice. In order to love, he must pour out his wrath. He must justly condemn sin. And so in this view, the reason why Jesus died was to satisfy God's wrath against sin. It was to satisfy the justice of God. Jesus stood in our place. He was a substitute by being the one on whom God vented his wrath. So now he doesn't have to vent it against us. And that's what allows him to now see us as innocent and to forgive us. It's called the penal substitution view of the atonement. Now, everyone agrees that Jesus died as our substitute, no question about that. But the question is, is that the way he was our substitute? Penal means penalized. He was punished for our sin by the Father, so the Father could vent his wrath on him. Is that view correct? Now, we tend to, while we totally believe that Jesus died as our substitute, we think that use of this scripture, that explanation for why there must be shedding of blood for the forgiveness of sins has gotten twisted. And it results in some people getting a pretty strongly misconceived view of God, who needs to be appeased before he forgives. So I'm going to raise five questions about this perspective.